Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing another travel video. Please like and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. Vidhana Soudha counts amongst the most impressive as well as the most magnificent buildings in the Bangalore city of India. It is mainly famous for housing the legislative chambers of the state government. Construction of Vidhana Soudha, sprawled across an expanse of 60 acres, the Vidhana Soudha is a glorious and opulent example of Neo-Dravidian style of architecture, with hints of Indo-Saracenic, Rajasthani and Dravidian elements adding beauty to the place and making it even more elegant. The 300 rooms of Vidhan Soudha accommodate approximately 22 departments of the state government. The building rises to a height of almost 46 meters, making it one of the most imposing structures in the city of Bangalore. History of Vidhana Soudha. Built in the year 1956, Vidhana Soudha of Bangalore boasts of exquisite Dravidian architecture. Then Prime Minister Shri Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru along with then Chief Minister K.C. Reddy laid down the first brick of this establishment on the 13th of July 1951 and initiated the construction of a monument that symbolizes the legislative sovereignty of the people of the country. Its construction took a good 5 years and it was finally inaugurated in 1956 to become the largest legislative building in India. The Vidhana Soudha stands 150 feet tall and boasts of an elegant and truly exquisite Neo-Dravidian style of architecture. Vidhana Soudha houses the State Legislature and the Secretariat of Karnataka and is one of the most popular attractions in the lively and colourful city of Bengaluru. It also proudly boasts the title of being the largest state legislative building in the country. Vidhana Soudha architecture, constructed purely out of granite and porphyry, Vidhana Soudha is adorned with four domes on its four corners. Embellishing the entrance of the buildings is the four-headed lion, the national symbol of India. The cabinet room has a huge sandalwood door, which has been beautifully carved. Vidhana Soudha of Bangalore can be accessed from all the four directions. However, the admission to the building has been restricted and one has to take prior permission before visiting its interiors. A temple dedicated to the nation is what Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru called Vidhana Soudha in Bangalore, which houses the state legislature along with the Secretariat of Karnataka. In addition to being amongst the top tourist places to visit in the city of Bangalore, it is also the largest legislative building in the entire country. Vidhana Soudha inside structure. Vidhana Soudha is a rectangular building with two inner open quadrangles on either side of the central wing. The northern wing consists of a ground floor and three upper floors. The southern wing has a cellar floor, a ground floor and three upper floors. The central wing has a banquet hall on the ground floor and a legislative assembly chamber above it. The legislative assembly chamber measures 125 feet by 132 feet and 40 feet high. The Legislative Assembly Chamber has seating accommodation for 268 members, with a provision to accommodate 100 more in the future. How to reach Vidhana Soudha? Vidhana Soudha is located around 34.8 kilometers from the Bangalore airport. The best way to reach this iconic structure from the airport is by taking the public bus service by BMTC to Ulsoor, which takes around an hour and a half. This is also the cheapest mode of transportation to Vidhana Soudha from the airport. Alternatively, you can also take a taxi or hire a prepaid cab like Uber to Vidhana Soudha. Taxis are usually the fastest way to reach here, taking around 35 to 40 minutes depending upon the traffic. The Vidhana Soudha is located at Ambedkar Vidhi, near Sampangi Ramanagara, in Bengaluru, Karnataka. It has the Karnataka High Court located opposite to it. The visitors should not miss the inscription, "Government's work is God's work," written on the top of the main entrance. Vidhana Soudha is also popularly known as the Taj Mahal of South India. At the moment, the structure stands tall at 150 feet, with an opulent and exquisite Neo-Dravidian style of architecture. This is one of the most important structures in Bangalore. The 46-meter-tall imposing building comprises 300 rooms, each of which reflects the impressive Dravidian style of architecture. Housing 22 departments of the Government of Karnataka, Vidhan Soudha also happens to be one of the largest legislative buildings and is a must-see tourist attraction in Bangalore. The best time to visit Vidhana Soudha is in the summer season, between the months of March and May, when the weather in the city is less warm and bright, devoid of any high temperatures or humidity. June to August are the monsoon months in Bangalore, when the city experiences heavy and torrential downpours. Lighting of Vidhana Soudha. The Vidhana Soudha is very famous for its magnificent lighting. Every Sunday evening, along with other special occasions, like Republic Day, Independence Day or Diwali, the entire structure gets lit up in millions of colourful lights, offering a stunning view to visitors and onlookers. The lighting of Vidhana Soudha is one of the most popular things that attracts thousands of people, locals and tourists alike. In addition to the lighting, there is also a mesmerizing light show, where numerous bright and vibrant lights engulf the structure. The slogan of Vidhana Soudha is "Government's work is God's work," which was engraved at the entrance of the Vidhana Soudha during the regime of the former Chief Minister of Karnataka, R. Gundu Rao. This slogan, along with its Kannada equivalent, is richly carved at the entrance of the magnificent structure that Vidhana Soudha is. In 1957, the Mysore government tried to get the government to change this slogan to "Satyamev Jayate," which means that the truth always prevails.